or they try to.
What in God's name is going on in here? What was that ruckus?
What ruckus?
I was just in my office and I heard a ruckus.
Could you describe the ruckus, sir?
Turn the fucking beat up!
What is that? What is that? What is that noise?
What noise?
Really, sir, there wasn't any noise.
The Alpine's bumping, but I need the volume higher.
Bring the motherfucking ruckus! Bring the motherfucking ruckus!
As I uplift this art form, ceiling high.
Hey, Papa.
What up, though? It's your boy, Low Gross, also known as Big Hollywood Skeetor. And this is episode 407 of the Inaudible Ruckus Podcast. All right, I know a lot of y'all was mad because even though we switched to every other week, last week we was late with the show, right? We're doing it this week. I know y'all like, what happened? Where's the show? What's going on? I went up to Dallas. Me and Inaudible Smiles had an event, you know what I'm saying, Culture Con, sponsored by Creators Don't Die up in Dallas. So I was up in there, you know what I'm saying? Smiles had put it together. So they had us doing a live podcast, you know, just kind of podcasting in the space. It was dope with all the different creatives. It was a fashion show, like a lot of vendor booths and everything, a lot of performances. It was photo shoots. It was crazy, right? It was beautiful to see, but we wanted to be out, you know, as we grow the brand and stuff, we want to be out and about and, you know, find and take advantage of those opportunities to, like, bring the podcast out to the people. You know what I'm saying? That's something that we've been trying to do. It's always been a little bit hard because, you know what I'm saying, me being in Houston, the rest of the guys being in Dallas, Free being in the West Coast, it's just different, right? So we're trying to find more of those opportunities. So I want to give a special shout-out to Mac Roni up in Dallas, man. He's always been a supporter ever since he appeared on the Music Impulse, man. But all-around good dude, man. He helped put the whole thing together and helped bring us into it. So I wanted to shout him out. So this episode that y'all gonna hear, man, we was there at the event just kind of hosting. While we were there, the beef between Kendrick and Drake was still ongoing. As y'all know, day by day, literally stuff was just dropping. But in the middle of the event, Kendrick dropped Not Like Us. They Not Like Us, and it went crazy. So we do have, you'll hear it in here, but we have, like, live reaction. Two young women decided to join us and wanted to give their thoughts, and they had a lot of good takes, right? They just jumped right in. They interrupted another interview and was so passionate that I just kept it rolling. You know what I'm saying? I'm a professional journalist. You know what I'm saying? I really do this. But then also want to give a special shout-out to B-Man. He's a second-grade rapper, right? Like, he's a child rapper and this and that, but he's cold, right? And then he had the opportunity to co-host a part of the podcast with us. We also did an interview with Eddie Valentino, who's a fighting instructor. He has a gym out in Dallas. Coach Adam, who's a life coach and mental health advocate. So he was on there. We also had Chrx Carter, who's an all-around musician, artist, creative. He sat with us. And a couple more. So, man, check this out. You know what I'm saying? We had them kind of in different segments, man. And it just kind of was a free-flowing event. And me and Smiles were just in there just kind of rolling with it. You know what I'm saying? But we had a good time. Hopefully some of the vibes came across in the audio, man. So, yeah, enjoy this, man. Again, shout-out to Mac Roni and everybody else that we got a chance to chop it up with. We're looking forward to doing many more of these in the future. So check it out, man. It's an Audible Ruckus. Motherfucker.
All right, y'all. You already know what time it is. Get ready for the most electrified man in podcast. So put your headphones on and sit back as we get ready to bring the ruckus, motherfucker.
Give me the mic so I can take it away.
Now the party didn't start till I walked in, and I probably won't leave until the thing ends.
What up, though? It's an Audible Ruckus reporting to you live from Culture Con in Dallas, Texas. I'm here with Smiles. We got a lot of activity going on around here.
Oh, yeah. It's booming.
Yeah, it's a room full of entrepreneurs and creators. So we're going to be interviewing them as they happen. While we here, you know what I'm saying? Like, we letting people just come chime in. It's a free-flowing show, man. We got mics plugged up, all of that. Smiles. Kendrick dropped while we was here at the event, so everybody stopped, went to the side, and was asking, like, all right, what do we do? Or, like, not what we do, but they was like, all right, let's listen and then come back. So as people going to be chiming in, we're going to be asking about the beef, other little situations as they jump off. But this is a free-flowing show, y'all. Mm-hmm. I know y'all like, what's going on? We ain't getting no episode on Saturday, even though y'all said y'all was 2 weeks in.
we here. You feel me?
It's just a little late.
But are you having a good time, Smiles?
Oh, yeah. I was like, we met some real dope people. It's a real dope vibe up in this building right now. I'm loving it. People are already mixing and mingling and, you know, trading business cards and all that.
Yeah.
Super dope.
Yeah. I'm having a good time meeting folks, man. So people going to come in. We're going to be interviewing them. We got topics teed up. But while we wait for that, Smiles, what you think about this new Kendrick drop, Not Like Us?
Yeah. If the battle was to end right now, we talking about Kendrick won.
Yeah. All right, B-Man, you back. So we would you a little young. I got it. I work the board. You the star now. Like, you introduced. So we got to we was talking about Kendrick and Drake.
Yeah, they dissed each other.
Yeah.
So you familiar? Even the kids know. Are you a fan of one or the other?
I don't know.
You don't?
I don't.
Okay.
But one of my favorite YouTubers, they're a fan, so I guess I'm a fan.
That works.
Okay.
That works.
Who are they a fan of?
Drake.
Drake? Okay, okay.
So Drake is for the kids.
Drake is for the kids, yeah.
What about Kendrick?
I do not know.
You don't know?
No.
No, are there any YouTubers out there that like Kendrick?
I do not know because I barely watch other people.
Oh,
that's smart. That's smart. You got to stay, like, keep your individualism that way. That's how you do it.
It's all about you and you.
Yeah. Are you having fun at the event so far?
Yeah.
That's good.
Meeting a lot of good people?
Yes.
I saw you out there earlier. You was actually playing football inside the event. Like, you was juking on everybody.
Yeah. Was that what's been your favorite part of the event so far?
Playing football.
Inside the event?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Hey, look, as long as you're having fun doing it, I guess. Is that your water juice?
Yeah. No. Okay.
All right. Hit it.
Yeah. Time for some it's joke time.
Show time, man.
No, joke time.
Joke time?
Joke
All right,
time.
Got some jokes. Tell some jokes. Tell some jokes.
What do you call a moose with no legs?
A donkey.
No.
What? A dog.
A boot.
A boot?
Yeah.
A boot.
A moose with no legs.
A boot.
See what you did there. That's funny. That's funny. That's funny.
Because, get it? You have to wear a boot if you have a broken leg.
I ain't get that one. I'm not going to lie to you, B-Man. I ain't get it.
Whenever you break your leg, you have to wear a boot, right?
Yeah.
But you
said a moose. You said, what's a moose with no legs?
Oh.
Yeah, you said a moose with no legs.
You forgot the joke. Come on, B-Man.
He said, hold on,
get it together. You had it. I was confused. I thought it was me. I didn't speak to that.
I was trying to imagine my head like, yo, this is for real, for real.
All right, you back to the party. All right, so I decided we was going to take a poll at the party as far as, like, who got who, Drake or Kendrick, you feel me? But we still waiting.
Yeah, they was actually playing all the disjoints earlier.
Yeah.
I was shocked. They started with Euphoria. I was like, okay.
Lo, it's your turn.
Yeah. So, question for you, B-Man. Are you performing tonight?
Only if I ask.
Okay, have you asked?
Have you asked?
No.
Why not? I heard you killed it.
Because I'm going to wait till like 9 so people can show up.
I got you. That's smart. That's how you're supposed to do that. Because sometimes when you come to these events, you perform too early, nobody sees you. You perform too late, nobody sees you. So you got to make sure you do
it. Nice ideal time, like 9 o'clock. You're like, okay.
Yeah. That makes sense.
Because if the event starts at 8, people show up an hour late.
Right. Yeah. That's smart.
And that rhymes.
It do. Put that in your next song. Who taught you that? How'd you know that you got to, like, wait till everybody get there if the event starts at 8?
Because I come to every event.
Okay.
Okay.
So you be out here.
You're a supporter. You really be out here in these streets.
Yeah.
And Mac, let them know as they coming in. Look.
Mac, you want to join our podcast?
We I got you. Look, we interviewing everybody, so tell me what they walking past. Come on in.
Yeah.
You
want to
join our podcast?
Yeah.
Come on.
Okay. Yeah. No,
hey, pop out. Pop out.
We here with our...
We at the CLTR Con. This is your boy, Mac Roni, man. I'm here with An Audible Raucous. You know what I'm saying? My boy, Skeet. You know what I'm saying? We in that bit, too. With my boy, Smilez over here, too.
If you see me trying to see us, Skeet. We rock.
Mac, tell us, how did CLTR Con come to be?
Basically, we created a... We created events in the Dallas area based towards... the culture, really, you know what I'm saying? So We used to call it Modern Day Art and Music Festival. We've named different names, but I was like, man, we need to put CLTR in our name, because that's what we do, and we bring in brands, models, photographers, artists all together. And, you know, a lot of people wouldn't even know each other if they didn't come to some of the events and stuff like that. So
that's
our goal, is just to intermingle everybody and bring the CLTR together, because we are the CLTR. From the art, to the music, to media broadcasting like you guys doing right now.
Hear an Oprah singer.
That's what brought it about.
Yeah.
Wants to hear an Oprah singer.
Heard I appreciate God, y'all coming. Man, I met him here because of you.
Yeah.
I didn't even know he was a rapper. He was over here, like, hey, I'm about to do a podcast. Oh, you about a podcast?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he rap.
Yeah. Who wants to hear an Oprah singer?
He was shooting his video yesterday up here.
Wants to hear an Oprah singer.
Wow.
We'll keep it. Somebody
in traffic right now getting their eardrums busted next Tuesday. Appreciate you, Mac, man.
Yeah, man.
But no, we having fun. We interviewing different people as they come in. B-Man, appreciate you as always.
I'm one of the hosts.
Yep.
All right. So you going to go find us some more people to interview? You going to invite them in?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Are they going to be number 4 or 3?
I don't know. We're going to figure it out. We'll figure it out as we go.
They should be number 4. All right.
So I'm going to get another plug and plug that in. We'll be back after this.
Yeah.
This was the CLTR Con. This was B-Man, Josh, and Lo. We out. Peace.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
Okay, what up, though? Y'all know what time it is, man. We are in here. This is An Audible Ruckus live from CLTR Con. I'm with Josh, B-Man. What up? Hit the button for me. We got our guest host, B-Man, joining us.
B-Man in the building.
B-Man 2016, man. How you feeling?
Good.
Good? Are you enjoying yourself at CLTR Con so far?
Yes.
They said that, so you did a video shoot last night.
Yep.
Heard and then what else? A movie tomorrow?
I'm doing a movie tomorrow. I'm going to church. And we had a game. We had 2 games today, actually.
Okay. What position you play?
I didn't play. But I'm center. I'm starting off center and cornerback.
Okay. That's cool. That's cool.
That's what's up.
Hold on. I'm going to grab some headphones. Go ahead. Keep talking.
Yeah. I love defense.
No. The only favorite that I have is my quarterback. Yeah, and the people that I've been with since I was in Tiny Tights, like since I first started. Say it again.
That's my quarterback. No, but you can still come back.
quarterback and my and the people that I've been with since I was 3 years old.
Okay, okay, okay. Who else is what other things you got working on right now?
Some songs.
Okay, what some songs you working on? Yeah. That better stand up. Be man in the building.
The video shoot that I did yesterday was for a song called Everybody Clap.
Everybody Clap.
And I got a song called Be Man This and Be Man That. And I got a feature song called called Just Wanna Have Fun. And then I got another feature song. We haven't did the video for both of them. We just recorded the song, but on Just Wanna Have Fun.
Mm-hmm.
The boy hasn't finished his first. The first time he did it, he was just freestyling. And he said that he was going to knock people out.
Okay.
But for the song that we're doing right now, we already have the song done. So all we need right now is a cover. And,
okay.
And the video.
Okay, okay. That's what's up. I can't wait to hear this new joint. This is going to be fire.
Yeah, that's hard.
My man, B-Man out here doing feature verses.
Did you kick the freestyle on him already? You already freestyled on him? You did that earlier, I thought. That's what I walked in on.
Yeah.
We got that, right? You was recording? Okay. Handle your business.
Yeah.
Handle your business. Yeah, all right.
Hello, and welcome to the Bigger and Better Podcast. I'm what the DJ B-Man, and you're DJ Rocky. Okay.
Okay.
And we have two special guests here.
Here, yeah, right.
One of them are named... what's her name?
What's your name?
Lo. One of them are named...
Is
Lo. Lo! How long have you been doing a podcast for?
Yeah. We said do what now?
How long have you been doing a podcast for?
So I've been doing a podcast for 8 years now.
Eight years?
About 8 years or two.
Okay. How long?
About 8 years.
Okay.
You too?
Yep, about to say.
Oh, crazy.
What do you do?
Biggest podcast in the world.
Push these. So you gotta keep these on. Always green means go, red means stop. Basically, is the best way to hear.
Wait, can you hear me?
Yes,
I can hear you.
Okay. Can you hear yourself?
I can hear myself.
He can hear you too.
Okay. So the reason we did this podcast is because we know how to do it bigger and better.
Podcast.
And because we're called the Bigger and Better Podcast. It's so loud. Rock and roll. Rock and roll.
Why you don't want to rock and roll, bro?
Okay. So, how long have you ever did music before?
Yes, I have.
How long have
how
you
long?
Ever did music?
For 3 years.
How long have you ever did music before?
I've only ever did music one time.
Sir, how long?
It was like 10, 11 years ago.
Dang,
wow.
Crazy.
We're both rappers.
Yeah.
Shoo!
Bigger podcast in the world.
That's sad. But you've only been doing music for... For only one time.
He said one time in 11.
Yep. I saw one time.
Serious?
And so, we're out. Peace. Hello and welcome to the Bigger and Better Podcast. Thank
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
And we have two special guests.
Yes.
Okay. We have Lo and
Josh.
And Josh.
Yes.
So we got Josh and how long?
Lo.
And who is you?
Lo.
No, Lo. How long have you ever, like, how do you have hair?
Yes, I have kids.
Hair.
You said hair?
Do you have kids too?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
How long have you been growing that beard?
When you was my age, when
four
what
years.
Do you used to
and
do?
I
used to ride my bike a lot.
What did you do as a
games.
Kid?
You said
that's
what?
It? What did you do as a kid?
I rode my bike a lot and I played video games.
Wait, I'm gonna pause it. Hello and welcome to
the biggest podcast.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Hello, look, and welcome to the Bigger and Better Podcast.
It's organic.
Woo. Thank you, thank you. Time for some rock and roll. DJ. DJ, let's play some more. Hey, DJ, thank you for all of this. Welcome. I like this Bigger and Better Podcast. Okay. We have two special guests. We have Lo and what's your name?
Josh.
And we have Josh. Okay.
Wait,
how long have you been?
Let me talk.
Okay, so we got Lo and Josh in the building.
Lo.
And Lo and Josh. Sorry for that pause.
Bow!
Tickle pop boom boom.
Stop! Bro, that's too loud. It's gonna burn my ears up to death.
When I think about God, rock and rolling.
Stop! Do you wanna hurt my ear?
Can't be true.
Time to pop some jokes. What okay. do you call a moose with no horns?
Moose horn.
No. A oose. A goose.
Hello and welcome to the
B-Man and Josh Show.
Thank you for all the praise. Are you ready for some rock and roll?
Yeah.
Rock on!
Yeah.
What do you want to do first?
So, let's tell each other some jokes.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
I don't know.
I don't know who.
I don't know how to end this joke.
Funny.
Your turn.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Outside.
Outside who?
Outside and around the corner.
If you get a rock on and the joke, then you get extra points. But if you just get the jokes, then it's just 1 point.
Okay.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Drake.
Drake who?
Kaka.
Drake who, Kaka?
Kaka means poop.
Oh, okay. Learn something new.
That's in Spanish. Kaka is poop in Spanish.
Okay. See, I don't know Spanish. I know like 1, 2, 3. That's all I know.
Uno, dos, tres. In Spanish?
Yeah, uno, dos, tres. That's all I know.
Okay. What should we do next?
I heard you're a rapper.
Yeah.
You want freestyle?
No.
Go ahead.
I need a beat. Yeah, it's a beat, man. I have to do this. Shadow money, man. I hope I make your list. I've been seeing stars like it's nighttime. And the only thing I'm supposed to get the answer my round.
Hey, go be man. Go be man.
Your turn.
Go be. Yeah, I'm sitting here with my man B-Man. You know he can do it better than he can, better than you can, better than I can. I'm here with my man B-Man. He got the 88 on his jersey. He,
99.
See? Nah, I'm getting my numbers all wrong. Hey, nah, I messed up the song.
It don't really matter if you mess up the song, right? Huh?
Yeah.
What do you mean you messed up the song? It don't really matter, because we're a rapper, huh? Oh. What? Let me get it. Mm.
Hey. Bars.
Where's 3 and 4?
It's just 1 and 2.
Where's the third mic?
There's no third mic.
Oh.
This is the B-Man and Josh show. We don't need a third mic.
What about Low?
No, it's the B-Man and Josh show.
And the Low show.
And the Low show. We've become the B-Man and Josh and Low show.
Yeah.
I don't think I signed that contract.
Why not?
Because I was told it was just the B-Man and Josh show.
Oh. So there's no 3 and 4? Well, let's switch to these mics.
Yeah.
Okay, this is the B-Man and Josh show. Yeah, rocking out.
What up, y'all? It's your boy Smilez, a.k.a. the hip-hop Adam Schefter, a.k.a. the Josh James, a.k.a. the pod-headed demon. I just wanted to let y'all know to tune into my show, The Music Impulse, Inside the Inaudiverse, every week. On this show, you got me doing one-on-one interviews with different people such as podcasters, artists, entrepreneurs, all types of people. You might even check out some of my episodes where I got family on it. You know, just get to know me a little bit more. Hey, just know, just tune into the show, The Music Impulse, every week, Inside the Inaudiverse. It's your boy Smilez, and I'm out.
Hello, this is Chrx Carter. With our special guest named
Lauren.
Yes, Lauren with a Y.
Lauren with a Y.
He's natural. He's natural.
All right. It's a hand clap.
So Lauren with a Y. Tell us, you here for Culture Con. What is there any type of particular art form that you do or anything? You selling stuff? What you doing?
Yeah. Today I'm here with my dad. He basically sells clothes. His brand called Sourdough Y'all, so okay. Get with him.
Okay.
He basically sells like t-shirts, women's clothing, men's clothing.
Just clothing?
Cool fits for, you know, whoever.
Okay.
For kids?
It's universal. Yeah. Oh,
got you.
Okay.
Got you. Is he selling the shirts now, or do you think he want to do an interview too?
Yeah, my dad's selling shirts right now. He sell them like, he got an Instagram page, so if y'all go
and
search up Sourdough, I can look it up for y'all, but it's about Sourdough Clothing, 93 Bread, that's who's by, so okay. Pop up.
Got you. And y'all based here out of Dallas?
Yeah, we based here out of Dallas. We from Dallas. My dad from Lancaster.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'm from...
Okay.
Got it.
Yeah.
How long have you been working for Sourdough? How long have you been doing it?
We really just started it this year. He came up with the idea. He told me I should do it too, but I haven't really decided yet. So we really just started this year, but it's been going good so far.
That's good. That means you gotta keep it going.
I have a clothing, but it's not really popping off. It's just $15 a piece. But my cousin has a store. His car is right there, that blue truck.
Okay.
And his store is all the way back there.
Okay. Nice.
And
nice.
Creative clothing.
Okay.
Creative with the K, clothing with the K. You can find us at Creative Clothing on Instagram. And yeah.
All right. I'm going to get at y'all.
Okay.
For sure. Merch is important.
Okay. Just got to check that out, too.
So Lauren, do y'all do a lot of these different shows, showcases and stuff?
Yeah, my dad does pop-up shops all around Dallas. This is my first one that I've been to, so it's pretty cool so far.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what's up.
So have you had any input on any of the clothing that y'all come out with?
I made a couple of things myself.
Nice.
And I really been liking how he's been doing it so far. It's like he really got a mind of his own, but I've been helping him, so.
Can we see the clothes?
My young mind into the outfits.
So, if you don't mind us asking, how old are you, Lauren?
I'm 17.
Okay. 17. Are you considering going to school for this, or is there a need to because you're just learning from your dad directly?
Well, I'm going to go to school just to have a backup plan.
Okay. Yes. Okay.
Can we see the clothes? Can we see the clothes?
Oh, we could definitely see the clothes. Gotcha. But I'm probably going to go to school for business, so I can do anything. Y'all ready to see the clothes?
Yeah.
But before we rock out, we got to hit it with some jam.
What up, y'all? It's your boy Free, aka Free Illuminati, aka Young Freezer Burner, aka the Black Peter Parker, aka Poon Knight. And I want y'all to check out Blurs in the Trap, the new podcast with myself and my boy Dr. Jones, dropping Indian Otterverse every Monday. Come check us out. Get all your daily blur content, you know, nerd culture from a Black perspective. We got other pods doing it out there that we support, and we wanted to add a little bit of our own flavor to the mix. So check us out every Mondays in the Anotiverse. Peace.
Hello, and welcome to the Culture Con podcast.
Yeah.
Okay, we have one special guest. My dad, a.k.a. RP.
RP in the house.
RP in the building.
What's up?
Man, appreciate you for joining us, man. We got B-Man co-hosting and everything, man. I know we got to chop it up beforehand, but for the listeners out there, tell them a little bit how you got started. I know you said that you got an online station. Tell us about the online station and how you got started with that.
So how I got started with the online station is basically... I moved to Dallas, Texas in 2009.
Okay.
Or when I went to, when I moved out here, I went to school for audio engineering. And by the time I got here, I started working with different artists around here. And one of the biggest artists I was working with was Wireframe. He got the song Pull Out the Mag.
Okay.
And the cool part while I was working with him, I met this girl out here that was doing stage plays. And we were just real cool. And so she would invite me out to her stage plays. And one of the girls that was at the stage play, she was like, hey, where you from? And I'm like, oh, I'm from Little Rock. Oh, I went to... So we found out we went to the same high school and stuff. She said, I want somebody I want you to meet. And network and stuff. I was like, all right, cool. So I had a big show that was supposed to happen in Little Rock with Wireframe. But some other stuff happened, and the show kind of got canceled. So when I came back, I hit up the old girl. And she put me on the phone. The guy had a radio show that he wanted me to pay to get on in downtown Dallas. And this was back in 2012. And I was like, I never really thought about radio at that time, but I was like, hey, I think that might be a cooler idea. I can help my people get on. And so what ended up happening is...
Get my people that stand straight. These niggas are sick. Get them on the mic. What is they talking about? What did he block?
So what ended up happening though?
We're gonna interview you next.
No, but what is there's nothing that Drake said. Drake is a seventh grader to understand everything that Drake said. Kendrick, you have to have a mind. Your mind has to be exercised. How the fuck can you compare? How the fuck can you compare Drake to Kendrick? There's no way.
You can't, but they still at it. It's like when the cool kid picks on the nerd.
He just plays. Listen.
Wait, I'm saying close. So are you not at
No, you can't do that. Kendrick, first off, let me tell you something. Now, this is the part that's going to really...
All right, y'all, this is the part that I told y'all about where, you know, we just had some people come hijack the show, but they had to get off their takes about Drake and Kendrick, man, so we just let it rock, man. This is the people's podcast. It's the voice of the people, man, so we just let it go. So check this out. This is exciting, I think.
If you vote Drake, don't ever be on this podcast again. If you vote Kendrick, what's the podcast all the time? And if this is Drake, this is you. Drake, that is you. And this is Kendrick. Drake, you're not better than Kendrick.
It's not the fucking same. So the thing about it is he was raised by a white woman. So he's coming from a white perspective. Yep. He don't have the black American perspective. And a lot of people, not even that other people, like black Africans in Africa have the same perspective as black Americans. We have a unique experience. Yep. And so the fact that we have that a unique experience, you are from Canada. You don't have our same experience. So you coming in and you trying to portray us, but it's easy to digest you. Do you know all Drake is popular because everybody is able to digest him?
Yeah.
It's fucking Mexican, white, everybody from different places. That's why he's international, because he is cosplaying black American. This he's not cosplaying black
Canadian. To Kendrick's
Canadian.
Point, that's what he said.
He's not cosplaying black Canadian.
No, he is cosplaying black Canadians because they all talk
he's
like Jamaicans.
Not.
They all Jamaican.
I mean, but there's so many different people in Canada. Canada is just like America. They have so many different people that came to Canada.
Yeah.
But he's cosplaying a black American. He don't have the black American experience to cosplay us. Yeah. But he's cosplaying us, and we allowed him to do this. That's why this nigga think that he can fucking stand and hold a match to Kendrick. Yeah. You cannot hold a match to Kendrick Lamar. You cannot.
All right. Now, can you just speak into the mic and tell everybody your name?
You cannot hold a match to Kendrick Lamar. You are not a black American. People like you because you're not black American.
Yeah.
That's the thing about it. People don't realize that. Black American, they love everybody that cosplay black American. You're not black American. You are a Jewish Canadian fucking person. With a black daddy that did not raise you. Your black fucking daddy from Memphis did not raise you. So really, in reality, how are you? You don't have the experience. You don't have the experience. You don't have the range. Stop acting like you are a hood nigga, because you not.
Toronto is tougher than you think it is.
Toronto is full of coons.
Oh, damn.
Are full of coons.
Right.
They full of coons and full of people from different places.
Yeah.
Coons to black Americans. Yeah, you a coon. To black Americans.
I ain't heard nobody call nobody a coon in like years.
Listen, but I'm saying, to a black American, listen to what I'm saying.
We keeping all this.
Sharita, listen to you don't know what I'm saying.
What do you have to say about all this, Sharita?
About what?
Drake and Kendrick.
I said what I said.
It wasn't on wax, though. It's on wax now.
Kendrick is better than Drake.
Kendrick. Drake is just melody.
Won. Drake
if you like
won.
Melody,
he
if you like,
is a stupid
like
Canadian.
More so beats, and you're more so into catchy music, you're catching on to the beat more than you're catching on to the lyrics. So when you listen to Kendrick, you're not really listening to the lyrics. You're like, oh, this beat trash. But you're not listening to the lyrics. But when you actually sit and listen to the lyrics, Kendrick ate that down.
He is cool. I like that.
That's real.
That's real.
He dropped the third song. He was like, I'm still trying to dissect 16 in L.A. He like the first song that dropped.
Right.
Okay, draw along. I want to see it. Kendrick is a lyricist. That's just who he is. He's always been a lyricist. He's always been known for his lyrics. He hasn't been known for, oh, that's a good beat. He's been known for his lyrics and the quality of music that he puts out. And he is
attaching himself to black Americans for the longest.
It's hip-hop.
Just like he attaching himself to Sexy Red. Because Sexy Red is the epiphany of a black, a ghetto stereotype.
Yeah.
He's attaching his, that's what he do. He attaches himself to people in their culture. You are a Canadian. Why can't you sing about what y'all do in Canada and we're in Canada?
That's fact.
You
though.
Don't. You sing about you Houston,
you're not wrong.
Atlanta, Vegas. Make that make sense. But you not you are Canadian.
It is facts, cause Drake also hold on to, like what she said, he hold on to not only just stereotypes, but he now has a thing. He always had a thing for Houston.
Yeah.
You know?
All facts. They love him in Houston.
Yeah. Yeah, so his fan base is not black. He created his music based off of Houston culture.
He stole Kurt Cobain's whole style.
A lot of his fan
style.
Base is
whole
not style. Black. Everything
That's
about
the thing
it.
About it. But a lot of his fan base is mixed, Mexican. They can digest him because he's not black.
So
when you digest, when you see a black person,
they love the flow. They love
the beat. He said it in his rap.
They love a mix of
genres. He said you rapping
genre.
Like you're trying to yep. free the
Drake
slave.
Drake is not just hip-hop.
He's pop.
Drake is everything.
But see, I had him winning the battle because he's so, like, not because he's better. It's because of the range and because he don't have no moral code, and this is war, and so he can stoop to any level. Kendrick is a real man. Like,
but if you also think about what the battle is, if you think about battle rap as a whole, it's hip-hop.
Yes.
So it's not about range. It's about lyrics. It's about what you're saying. It's about how you're landing.
Yep.
It's not about the range that you have when you
hip-hop,
think about hip-hop.
Hip-hop
is lyrics.
Hip-hop have never been played in a club. It's not a bop. These are girls that want to dance to a hip hop. They don't know anything about hip hop.
They don't know about hip hop.
They talking about I want to dance to it. This beat is this. It's not that. It's about eating a motherfucker up.
It's the lyric.
In that song.
So y'all didn't like push ups when he dropped that
it
first push up?
Cool. It was cute. It was cute. It was cute.
No, I gotta ask you the same thing I asked her. So you ever been in the club, hookah, all of that, bumping Drake, dancing to Drake, any of that?
To be honest, I really can't recall. I'm not gonna lie to you.
That's fair. That's fair.
Think about it. I can't even recall Drake playing in a club. I don't know. Maybe I'm losing my mind. Drake plays in a car.
Yeah.
But I don't know if I was in a club and was like, damn, play that Drake.
Well, see, in Houston, that's all they play in the club is Drake. So, like, yeah.
I got one last thing to
what
say.
What song do they play in the club in Houston? Maybe I'm lost.
You said as far as Drake?
Yeah.
That Kiki, do you love me? In my feelings.
Yeah. I heard that in the club. Yeah. It's so old. That's like 2016, 17.
Yeah. But every other one that he dropped, some of that stuff that was on More Life. What was the last album he dropped?
Certified Lover Boy.
Yeah.
They played
yeah.
a couple of them joints. A lot of the stuff. Jimmy Cooks from him and 21 Savage. That shit.
Okay, with 21 Savage, that's the only reason why the song was played in the club, because of 21 Savage.
Yeah.
The only reason, only if you think about it, the only songs that Drake has that plays in the club is with the feature.
Yeah,
that is true. That is true. Because all the other ones he whining on.
A Drake solo song played in the club. It has to be a feature of an artist that's hot at the time.
Yeah, look,
it's never been Drake
last
solo.
Years, it's been 21
if you think
Savage
about Drake when his first album, not his first album, but even his first mixtape, going back with him and Trey Songz,
mm-hmm.
but even still, think about Take Care. They're not playing none of that in the club. That was a
that's
whole
true. That's true. That's
yeah.
true.
That was hey. The actual Drake.
Yeah.
But now yeah. he's just going with yeah. what's hot.
Yes.
I don't know.
Woo. Woo.
That's real. That's Woo. Real. Thank you.
I love the breakdown, y'all. Y'all get it.
You feel better now? You got that
yeah,
off your
no,
chest?
Yeah, no, I just got one last thing. Drake is the... He is... That is the... What is the word? I got lost in my
so
word.
Bad.
But he is the cause of letting people cosplay Black American. We let any and everybody portray Black American, and he is... What it is to cosplay, he is the result of us not gatekeeping Black America. Black America, we have a culture. We let people talk about how we don't have culture, all this other shit. But we see how people come in and they steal our culture. How the fuck we let a biracial man steal a biracial man that's not even American?
Yeah.
I can see if he was American, you're not even American. You stole our culture, you sat there and you're benefiting in front of us. And everybody is saying that you are the best person in hip hop, but you were never born into this shit.
That's true.
But the thing
that
about
is the
it
knock
is
against
because
him.
you have a white mother, a white Canadian Jewish mother. How the fuck did we let that happen? That's because Black people don't gatekeep what we have.
You're saying we sold out.
We don't
out.
Have no pride.
So we sold out is what you're saying.
We
as a people.
Literally did. We literally sold
That's
out.
That's fair.
When really in reality, and he beat us at our own game. And
he
this
did.
Is what they did. They did this to us 100 years ago. The thing about it is, this is how they stole us as slaves. Because we were so nice to them, we gave
nah,
them
well, nah, hold on. They didn't steal us as slaves. Our own people still sold us off to the slave owners. They didn't
but
kidnap
they,
us all.
No, they showed us about, they showed us They we showed them weapons and all the other stuff. They still doing that to us today. We still showing these people how to do certain things.
That's true.
And
That's
they're
true.
Stealing from us.
This is the result of that. We constantly being kind. We constantly letting people in on what we got going on.
Yeah.
And then we are the losing
and
team.
Then they take it.
There's people in South Africa right now that can't even own their own land. How the fuck you can't own your own land? Y'all sold y'all people. Y'all still can't own your own shit. There's people in Nigeria.
People don't talk about that the way they should.
They don't got a grip of their shit. Black people, these are the results of it. And then it's like we sitting here, we constantly letting people, because you let a black man nut in you, you saying, oh, this person is black. No, this person is bi-fucking racial. This is not a black person. This is a biracial person. It takes two fucking black parents to make a black person.
Yeah.
Outside of that, you're biracial. And that's just it. And it's the fact, and it's even just as Barack Obama, you're biracial. I don't give a fuck.
So biracial people can't say nigga then, right?
You could. I mean, really, in reality, because you could. Because let me tell you something. Let me tell you, you could because of how free we let fucking people do shit to us.
We let Mexicans say nigga
all the time. We let people do shit to us, and we sit there and we get our ass whipped. We still in slavery. That's the fucking reason why.
If it's five Mexicans standing out there and they say nigga,
still people don't know how to people don't know how to stand up for themselves.
That's true. I'm not about to get jumped by five Mexicans for telling them not to say nigga. No, that's not gonna happen. I keep walking.
I learned that when I moved to Taylor. I was like, oh, right, y'all say nigga.
Real fast. I'm getting ready to drop a bomb.
Yeah,
it's still the fact that they think that having a white partner is winning.
Yeah, there's people that think that. All right, we're going to take a break.
Yeah.
No, I'm going to put that on. I'm good. They.
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nay Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
Corey, you're right. Thank you, Smiles. What up, though? We up in here again. It's Culture Con. Excuse the noise, man. We having a good time having a party. B-Man. Young B-Man had to go take a break. We got Chrx Carter in the building. Chrx, what's the word?
What's up, baby? We in here, man. This is crazy, dude.
Yeah.
Vibe is nice.
Yo, I love it. It's colorful. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Love that,
So we linked up with you during setup.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? You fell through. Like we got to chop it a little bit.
Man.
So you're a bit of a jack of all trades, though, right? So you do music, production, video. Videography and
photography.
Okay.
I'm just a creator, man. I feel like God gave me that gift, you know, so I try to use all of them, you know what I mean? So
yeah.
You
got to
do.
So we was talking a little bit about balance because you said you got your family and stuff
absolutely,
at home, right?
Absolutely.
We only got a certain amount of time before the pumpkin turns into.
They about to go to bed in a minute. I'm going to get that FaceTime in a minute, you know what I'm saying? So
talk a little bit because we got a lot of creatives in our audience and stuff. How do you feel about this, like, balancing the creative process
the
as far as family time and time with your, like, and time on your art?
Absolutely. Like I said earlier, bro, like, my kids are a big influence in my life, like, not just my career, but my life, you know what I'm saying? So
uh-huh.
I like to keep them close to me, especially during my creative process. What's up, brother? I like to keep them close to me, you know what I'm saying? But, I mean, you hear the music, you'll hear that light or that, you know, that childlike creativity coming through there, you know what I'm saying? So they're very close to to my process, you know what I'm saying? So
that's good. It keeps you inspired.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely, bro.
And you hear that, though, because a lot of people, when they perform and stuff, right, they need a lot of weed, smoke, a lot of stuff to get going.
Bro. No, not at all.
But if your daughter's just over there playing
Come
and giggling
on.
And laughing,
hey,
that's all you need sometimes.
Especially if they like it, bro. We're gonna take it and run with it, you know what I'm saying?
B-Man, you back?
Yeah.
There you go.
Hello, and welcome to the...
Culture Con.
What's up, B-Man?
So, B-Man, that's Chrx. That's Chrx.
Hello, Chrx. What are you talking about?
What's up, B-Man?
Ask him the questions.
Let's go, bro. I love this. I love this.
Yeah.
We got our guest correspondent, B-Man, in the building.
You got it?
B-Man got his hand on the phone.
There you go, buddy.
Right.
Thank you.
I want to record this. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Kendrick or Lamar?
Yeah, so Chris, we need you to tell us Kendrick or Drake, because we just got chewed out about anybody who voted for Drake.
You know how
I had a poll going trying to get everybody, you know what I'm saying, Kung situated and whatnot.
Come on, bro. We're going with Kung Fu Kenny, baby.
Okay.
He's throwing out all the daggers, you know what I'm saying?
Now, why you pick Kenny?
Kendrick, I'll put it like this, bro. I mean, he talking about it right now. Kendrick coming to him on a spiritual level. Honestly, the angle, like you said, he kind of predicting Drake angles and everything.
Yeah.
Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not just going to totally throw Drake away. You know what I'm saying?
But, I had Drake for the win. Yeah, but I told you offline, because he ain't got no morals.
5-0, bro. No morals.
He ain't got no morals.
I'm a man of morals, you know what I'm saying? Right. So, of course, I'm going with my man Kung Fu Kenny, bro. Like,
I'm Kendrick.
Bro, this is crazy. Crazy.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
And he literally was like, yo.
But I'm with all the smoke, though. I mean, you know.
It's hip-hop.
We've been talking about cultural vultures for a long time.
Hip-hop for 50 years.
What's done
years.
In the dark always come to light. You know what I'm saying? So that's where we at right now. You feel me?
And, like, even the angles that he's taking. I swear. By, like,
bro, come on, man.
Him being, like, a pedophile. Like, bro, I did not expect Kendrick to
let me tell you
like
something. Meet the Grahams was sound like a horror movie to me, man. That's a horror movie.
It sounded like therapy.
Meet the Grahams.
Like it was like a horror therapy movie.
Bro, let me tell you something, bro. I got on Mortal Kombat at like 1:30 last night. I just had it. That's how that track sounded. You know what I'm saying?
Sure. So the young ladies that was in here, I thought they was gonna pick Drake. They went super woke on us and
serious?
Was like, "How dare you?
Are
he don't you have serious? His black daddy. He knows nothing about our
He's
culture."
Robbing the culture.
And so then I asked him. I was like, "Have y'all ever been in the club?" And he came on. No, I haven't heard it. I'm like,
"Bro,
all right." Because in Houston, that's all they play in the club.
For real, what's Drake? Yeah, I mean, that's anywhere. Sure. You know, he rep Houston a lot as well.
But I thought it would have been up here, too. But either they don't go to the club
You know, times have changed a lot as well. You know, a lot of stuff that used to be on the radio used to be in the club. You know what I'm saying? Now you kind of got the separation of the radio and the club where artists strictly make music for the club. Lately, that's been Drake. You know what I'm saying?
Well, and a lot of times, radio responds to what's going on in the streets.
That's right. Yeah, that's absolutely
right. It's more reactive.
Absolutely.
Back in our time, it was proactive.
Yes, bro.
Now it's reactive.
And then we got
ketchup now.
Bro, we got social media where you can get new music instantly. You don't have to wait for it anymore. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Or the artist has more time to choose when they want to drop instead of this is the time, you know, time frame or whatever. Like, it's...
The last what, 4 disses we've gotten were all like straight to YouTube.
Bro, come
first.
On, man, straight, bro. We got a diss last night after a diss, 30 minutes after that. You know
what even with podcasting, like we're doing the audio part now, that's why we're trying to work on even with our brand incorporating the visuals because everything is straight to YouTube.
That's right, yeah.
And that's the business model where your art, as we in here with all the creators, your art, you could just put it straight up on YouTube and just put your own dollars and get your own marketing dollars behind it. That's the plan.
Me as an artist as well, I had to figure out how I wanted to. There you go, brother. How I wanted to distribute music. You know, you just find the tools, you know what I'm saying? And I used to treat myself like I had a million fans waiting on my music, but.
Yeah.
Bro, go ahead and keep dropping. So now I try to drop as much as I create. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Keep a balance up there. You know. So.
That's real.
My guy controlling his.
Yeah, he is. I'm trying to make sure everything teed up the way it's supposed to.
Yes, sir.
Got you.
All good though.
But no, man, Chris.
Let's do some jokes.
Is he on there?
Yeah, all right. What's the jokes? Give us the jokes.
What do you call a moose with broken legs?
What do you call it?
A boot.
I can't hear that, but that was pretty funny, though.
If you say so.
That was cool, bro. That was good.
Yeah.
For real. Right. Start somewhere, man. You know, Richard Pryor. You know?
No, stay rapping.
Stick to the show for show.
Lo, it's your turn.
All right. Oh, crack a joke?
Yeah.
I can't tell none of my jokes on here.
Josh, your turn.
Yeah, shout out to Inaudible Records, man. We
all
up
day.
In here, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Taking
some ruckus, you know?
Yeah, bring the motherfucking ruckus.
Chrx Carter once again, yo.
Yeah. No, Josh, it's your turn.
And Chrx, we for sure going to have you interview on the Music Impulse.
Okay, this is Culture Con, and we out.
We out. Peace.
What up, y'all? It's your boy Smilez, a.k.a. the hip-hop Adam Schefter, a.k.a. the Josh James, a.k.a. the pod-headed demon. I just wanted to let y'all know to tune into my show, The Music Impulse, Inside the Inaudiverse, every week. On this show, you got me doing one-on-one interviews with different people such as podcasters, artists, entrepreneurs, all types of people. You might even check out some of my episodes where I got family on it. You know, just get to know me a little bit more. Hey, just know, just tune into the show, The Music Impulse, every week inside the Unautiverse. It's your boy Smilez, and I'm out.
All right, okay. Introduce us.
Okay, welcome to Chrx Carter.
All right, who we got on the mic, man? Introduce yourself.
Hey, yo, my name is Eddie. Eduardo, Eddie Valentino.
Okay.
Some people know me as Coach Eddie.
Coach Eddie.
Yeah. Are you a football coach?
Huh?
Are you a football coach, soccer coach, what kind of coach?
I'm a boxing coach.
Boxing coach. Okay.
That's scary.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I own a gym in Cedar Hills called Skills Sports and Fitness Complex.
Okay. Did you used to box professionally before you coached, or you just went straight to coaching?
I have an MMA background, actually.
Okay.
MMA background. And, you know, it started real early, man. My father owned an MMA gym back in the day, so I just grew up in the gym, really.
Gotcha. So is your
dad, I continued what he was doing.
Is your dad old school MMA, like before it got popular? Because remember, it was a popularity thing, but remember the old school MMA, they was just
when I was
out.
Coming up, it was just getting popping.
Yeah.
You know, it was almost taking over boxing, almost. It was growing.
That.
It was big. It was growing fast.
I ask you about that because when it comes to this, and we ain't got to go on through it. I want to talk more about the fighting, but the battle against Kendrick and Drake, right?
Yeah.
We've been talking about how it's different styles.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So talk about that as a fighter, just about like you got some people that do Brazilian jiu-jitsu.
Yeah,
you got
for
some people that's more boxing, some people more wrestling.
I mean, we can just keep it straight boxing. Like, you know, you have to be dynamic. You got to have the high guard. You got to have the shell. You got to have, you know what I'm saying? You got to be able to play around with your hands down. You gotta have good footwork. You gotta be dynamic.
Footwork is underrated, I feel like. A lot of people just be focusing on it, but
yeah, exactly.
Footwork is the best.
Yeah.
You gotta be dynamic. So you know, Kendrick is just being more dynamic right now.
What is
you know,
that?
The
what
AI shit from Drake was cool.
Yeah, I ain't
it
really
was
like
weird.
It.
It still had Drake's flow though. It wasn't dynamic.
Yeah.
What
it had the same style on a different person. Just you know what I'm saying? So I mean, it's pop rap, and it sounds good. Oh no, Drake shit is more sonically pleasing.
Yes, exactly.
Drake shit is more sonically pleasing. Yes.
Yeah, but Kendrick's the stuff you gonna think about.
Yeah, and years from now, and it makes you just like, oh damn, okay, there's different layers of this shit. You know what I'm saying?
And that's where something like small, like the footwork, you're not gonna really know. Like, oh, like no, you ain't know that he always do this. Whatever,
exactly.
Whatever
he,
you know, throw the jab or whatever.
Right. See, he just does. He does it all. You know what I'm saying? He'll rap you.
So as far as your gym, like how? Because I'm seeing now with business owners, the membership model is the best way to go as far as like sustaining that. Do you go that way, or do you like? Or your how do you design like your packages as far as fighters, or do you pick the fighters that you want to like train in your gym?
Now, with the professionals that I manage and I coach, I get a percentage.
Okay.
What's your percentage?
But
10%?
Regular classes, I charge a monthly membership.
$90.
And I also offer personal training packages.
Okay.
So one-on-one packages, there's group classes, and then I treat, there's a whole different business model for my pros.
Got you.
You know, and then I also
the ones that you know got the potential to really.
Yeah. You know, and then I also rent the facility to other trainers as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
I say that because, too, right, that's a good revenue model. You've seen in the pandemic a lot of people switch to the fitness side and the boxing side, but they don't quite know how to, like, build out the revenue stream.
Man, the pandemic, it made me move from group classes to personal training.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I literally had cops pulling up to my spot making sure we weren't gathering. Like, I think that shit was deep. I think they were trying to stop humans from gathering, and you know what I'm saying? It was some weird shit. I literally had cops out there threatening $10,000 fines if I held a class.
Wow.
And so I ended up just talking to these cops, you know, connecting to the person in them. And I was like, look, I'm just doing one-on-one training.
Yeah.
We got masks on. We got this. And so I actually had to adjust and create a different business model during the pandemic.
Yeah.
And then after pandemic, it's even better than ever. You know what I'm saying? So sometimes you just got to roll with the punches.
That's it.
Create some shit. it might even end up better.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, yeah. Because look at you now. It's all these different elements to it. That's what's up.
Mm-hmm.
Now, speak about the how you say, like, you just got to roll with the punches. Speak about, like, the importance of how did you learn that you got to really just whatever comes.
I mean, I got no choice.
Yeah.
Shit. If I didn't,
that's survival.
That was my own revenue. The group classes was my main memory.
You're right.
So once they stopped the group classes, I had to do something.
Yeah.
So, you know, it took a little pressure to create another revenue stream, but
here you are.
You got to roll with it.
Yeah.
Why couldn't you do group classes?
Because during the COVID time.
Yeah.
The COVID time, they didn't want people to gather together because they were saying, oh, it's spreading this disease. It's spreading this thing, you know?
Can you do them now?
I can do them now, yeah.
Yeah.
They got a little bit more lenient on these humans gathering together laws. You know?
So Eddie, we in here with all creatives and business owners and stuff, right?
Yeah.
For those people that's out here listening, what would you tell them as far as hold on a second. What would you tell them as far as, like, persevering and adapting to what's going on? Like what you just told, but what advice would you give to somebody that's looking for their thing that they're trying to do?
That's all of it. It's all just consistency.
Yeah.
Consistency, 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 adapting. You know, not surrendering to any obstacle that comes to you. Just keep going. It's going to pop. Yeah. That's it. Every
you gotta
day.
Believe.
Just do it every day. Just do it every day. You got to feed shit energy. You got to feed shit time and energy, and they'll create.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
If you don't feed shit time, energy, and consistency, it ain't going to create.
Yeah.
That's
for
it.
Sure.
It's really that simple.
Mm-hmm. Now,
you know?
Have you had any of your fighters that you've worked with, any of them, like, start to, like, bubble? Is there anybody that we should be on the lookout for?
Say again?
Any of your fighters that you've been working with that we should be on the lookout for, are they starting to really make
sure.
that noise?
For sure. Okay, so I had Samuel Clarkson. I call him Alex Clarkson. He just fought Dimitri Bivol not too long ago. That was for a world title shot.
Okay.
You know? He came up short on that one. Right now we have Samuel Arnold. He's 9-0. He's about to be 10-0 on the 18th.
Okay.
May 18th. He's fighting in Toronto. He's about to be 10-0. This boy is different.
Yeah.
This man is different.
Yeah.
No free. He's not a boy no more. This man is different. I'm telling you, inside, out the ring, just an outstanding person. His name is Samuel Arnold.
Okay. Okay.
Remember that name. Samuel Arnold.
Bet.
Okay? He's going to be a world champion.
I believe.
He's really good. He's different. He's disciplined. Good dude.
That's a key trait to have in a boxer.
Yeah. Very disciplined. He's different. He's a champion.
For sure.
Inside and outside the ring. Samuel Arnold, all right? I'm telling you right now.
Got you. Yeah, Coach Eddie, man, appreciate you, dog.
Hey, appreciate you, man.
Yes.
All right. Last thing, tell them about the gym, where they can find the gym at and everything.
Man, if you're in the Dallas area and you're looking for a good boxing gym, I'm in the Cedar Hill area. It's called Skills Sports and Fitness Complex. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook, Skills Sports and Fitness Co.
Okay.
Gotcha. We're 1017 South Cedar Hill Road. I hope to see you there.
Bet. Appreciate you, dog.
Thank you, man.
Yes.
Yo.
What up, y'all? It's your boy Free, aka Free Illuminati, aka Young Freezer Burner, aka the Black Peter Parker, aka Poon Knight. And I want y'all to check out Blurs in the Trap, the new podcast with myself and my boy Dr. Jones, dropping Indian Otterverse every Monday. Come check us out. Get all your daily Blur content, you know, nerd culture from a Black perspective. We've got other pods doing it out there that we support, and we wanted to add a little bit of our own flavor to the mix. So check us out every Mondays in the Otterverse. Peace.
But that's how you know he the real cameraman, bro. Like,
right.
I'll be on this. Look, when I first started doing my visual shit, I'll pick up my nose and shit on this shit, bro. Like, bro, you know they can see you.
Oh, glare. Like, you can see that glare, right?
Yeah. check.
We back.
All right. Look, these are just segments. I'm just editing these together as segments, man. We got different people that we interviewing as we go throughout the function and whatnot.
Yep.
All right. Tell us your name and what you do.
All right. So my name is Coach Adam Morris. I am your gifted purpose life coach. What that means?
That is four. All right.
So I'm going to start this over.
Go ahead.
All right. So I am a mental and behavioral health life coach.
Okay.
Okay. Can you explain that too? For those of us like me that don't know what that means?
Absolutely. So first, let me give you my tagline, because I am a full, real entrepreneur. My name is Coach Adam. I am your gifted, purpose, life coach. What that means is I help you use your gifts so that you live life in purpose, on purpose. And a mental health life coach. So do you know what a... Well, first, I'm going to ask you like I ask my students. We work with youth all over the city.
Okay.
So what is a coach?
Somebody to help motivate you and keep you accountable to your development plan.
Keep you accountable to your development. Would you agree?
Yep.
Okay. Okay. So a coach for your life would do what?
Keep you accountable for the things you said you're going to do in life.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So that's a great example and definition. So, yeah, that's what I do. I'm a mental health life coach, primarily working with kids. And I work with the Global Institute for Coaches and Entrepreneurs, a.k.a. Jice Loves.
Okay.
For short, we are the only life coaching institution in the United States that is medically credentialed. If you don't know what that means is we build through Medicaid insurance.
So okay.
The people that really need mental health support.
So y'all can really help the people who need it then.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Because that's the barrier. Like, we the resources is out here, but because of insurance and all that other stuff, our people don't have access to it.
Well, yeah, so Master Coach Kendrick, she solved that problem and created an additional way for people who do this work to do it and create a stream of revenue for themselves and help people. I call myself a changepreneur. I don't just make dollars. I make change. That makes sense?
Yeah, for sure, for sure. Now, so, Coach Adam, I just started therapy at the beginning of March. So I'm early in my journey or whatever, but what can you tell the listeners as far as like the importance of and like, or how soon do you recommend that we should start it? Because our people, black people in the inner city, like we go through a lot of trauma early on. How early do you think we should start? And then what do you think as far as the benefits of how it helps?
Okay. So first, let me start off with a little bit of transparency.
Okay.
So I was raised by a single parent mother. I was molested. Didn't have my dad in my life. I grew up in the hood.
Mm-hmm.
Grew up around a lot of strong black women. There was just a lot of trauma that I didn't realize that I had.
Yeah.
Mental health issues genetically in our family.
Yep.
It took someone showing me real unconditional love.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that was the owner of this company, Kendrick Smiley. And that helped me unpack how my mental health issues was affecting me. So to answer your question, why it's important, it's because people are walking around hurting people, especially our people.
Yeah,
hurt people.
Yeah.
We're walking around hurting each other versus just showing love and compassion and empathy for another person. And 9 times out of 10, the issues or flaws that you see in someone else are the same issues you see within yourself.
It's projecting. We walk around projecting shit on each other.
I wouldn't say projecting. We walk around as a mirror, as a reflection. If you see me, you should see you. I am your brother.
Yeah.
So, our company teaches people to lead with love. That's our big thing. International, we're all over the world. We're in Africa, we're in Asia, in Manila, Philippines, Kenya. We have some female coaches in Kenya. And our goal is to teach people how to lead with love.
Yeah.
And if you want to be a life coach, similar to me, I've been doing this work for a few years here in Dallas, like community development, working with kids, Like I said, this young man here, I took his first photo shoot, the 8-year-old rapper. Yeah. What's his name?
B-Man.
B-Man, 8-year-old rapper. But that's like literally what I do. I'm out here in these streets working with kids, building the community, working with the police department, working with anybody that wants to impact change.
Mm-hmm. I got to stop you right there. Mm-hmm. Talk to me about how has the work been with the police department, right? Because I'm from Detroit.
Yeah.
I grew up in Detroit. I said this on the pod many a times. My interactions with the police growing up have not been positive. I've had a gun in my face at least 6 different times. All 6 of them have come from the police. So as you are on the front lines of kind of mending and managing that relationship in the community, how has that, like, how has it been trying to, like, find common ground on those two sides?
Yeah, so first I want to say that's a great example as to why we need life coaches, why you can definitely start your therapy journey or your coaching journey to help heal from that, so that when you do encounter the police, you know how to approach them. You don't have these biases and stigmas from trauma and from past experiences when you're dealing with the police. So I say that if you have any kind of reservations working with the police, you the problem.
Okay.
Get you a therapist. Get you a life coach. And it's okay to not be okay. It's okay to have issues. It's okay to go through things. It's okay to need help.
Yeah.
So, working with Dallas Police Department, to answer your question, shout out to Officer Joe Tobert, Police Officer of the Year last year.
Okay.
So, I work with him in the BFL area. That's Best for Less. That's Sweet Georgia Brown. That's what Big Mama wanted. I work in that community with the Dallas Police Department, and it's been great.
Yeah.
Officer Tober, his motto is Mr. Accountability.
Okay.
Okay.
Like, making sure that people do what they say they're going to do when they say they're going to do it.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what we need more of.
And right, right.
And, like, he's been awesome in us going into schools in that area, Obama Male Leadership Academy, Frederick Douglass Todd Elementary School, Ulysses S. Grant, like, all of those communities. Shout out to Fort Oak Cliff, Taylor, and people that are pouring into that area.
Yeah.
So my experiences has been great, but I'm a little biased because I grew up with a cousin who all he wanted to do is be a police officer.
Okay.
Play with the Hot Wheel toys. When we played with Legos, he was always the police officer.
Mm-hmm.
He became one of the first black, youngest black sergeants in Arlington Police Department.
Okay.
So when I think of the police, I think of them like my family.
Okay.
You know, because that's one thing, like, you know, I'm from the hood. Like, you know how people view
it's
police.
It's a stigma,
you know,
on it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But for me, I'm like, I just want my cousin to come home. Like,
yeah,
I love him. He does a very dangerous, thankless, underpaid job.
Because, like you said, though, like, if
he
it's
sees
a
humanity in it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If it's a traffic stop or something, right, he don't know what they thinking on the other side, you know what I'm saying, as they walking up to the car. Like so it is a certain level of empathy there, especially having family like that. But I think that it's so crucial for you to kind of, I won't say manage that, but like to operate in that space, right, in that gap, to bridge that gap, right? Because there's people that think like me, but then there's other people out there that's looking for like closure, or looking for an opportunity, like, to feel safe, right? They looking to these people to protect them, right?
Yeah, and I think that just learning from, you know, another lifetime, I used to work at Frito-Lay, and they had this motto, like, if you see some trash on the ground, don't pass it up, pick it up.
Okay.
Don't blame other people, like, why they just walking by, ain't nobody picking up the trash, or, you know, when somebody,
take,
you know,
responsibility.
Take responsibility, yeah. Take accountability, be the change that you want to see. And that's something else that we develop at JICE, is different types of life coaches. Like, my thing is gifted purpose, using your gifts. God gave everybody a gift, just like a fingerprint. That gift will sustain you in life. I just made Adrian Brown, shout out to Adrian Brown and Yellow Beezy. I just made Adrian, but he's Yellow Beezy manager. I just made him a life coach with the institution, and he just does his lane. Music therapy, going into the schools with us, developing his time, still being an artist, the Yellow Beezy, but developing his gift and what he likes. And his son, actually, I don't want to tell his story, but his son actually has mental health issues, and using music as an escape to get out has not only helped him with his mental health, but developed some great, like, high-level clients for him.
Yeah, that's dope.
That's great.
That's dope, man.
To kind of go back a little bit just to what you were talking about the police, have you had to deal with any police on the other end, having to, like, teach them and show them, like, how to show empathy to, like, the people that you work with?
So, No, because I'm a life coach and you gotta pay me for that.
Yeah, gotcha. Gotcha. Okay. Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
Shout out to the Dallas Police Department. I will do a RFP or a bid, and I would love to teach the police how to lead with empathy and love.
But they gotta bring you in for corporate training.
You got to pay me because I do this for real. And I don't work for free because it's just not sustainable. I think the easiest and quickest way to go broke is to do a bunch of shit for free.
Yeah.
He had to teach me that our podcast.
I started charging people for interviews and
you better. How you gonna sustain?
That's what I'm saying. Now, Coach Adam, talk to me about this though, because you mentioned that you had your traumas and stuff that you had to endure, right?
Right.
And I see a lot of you paying it forward in your mission and in your path.
Mm-hmm.
It sounds to me like because you are the one who helps a lot of people, they always say like check on your strong friend, right?
Yeah.
Like check up on the people who carry other people's burdens.
Yeah.
How do you personally like compartmentalize like what you do and then the people that you help? Like how do you go about balancing that?
Compartmentalize. So I would first say that life coaching is a lifestyle. And luckily for me, I have a tribe of people that do the work. So the hardest part about being a life coach is doing the work yourself.
Yeah.
Do the work yourself. Be the change you want to see. It sounds cliche, but that's the real shit. Doing that inner work, healing from that trauma, healing
shadow
from those
work.
Experiences.
Yeah, yeah.
Shadow work, inner work, whatever the fuck you want to call it. Work on yourself. You the problem.
Yeah.
You the problem. You are the center of your universe. So if you ain't happy, fix it. Change it. Do better. Show love. So I compartmentalize by doing the work. I have a whole tribe of people. Shout out to Jice Loves. Shout out to our tribe. We was just on a Emmy Award winning show, Destination Dallas. Shout out to the tribe because I know all of them do their own work.
Yeah.
And I can come to you and say, like, when you said this, when you did this, it made me feel like this. You know, just making sure that, you know, I continue to be the person that I am always. Whether I'm at the club, whether I'm drinking, whether I'm in the schools with
yeah,
the kids,
yeah.
Whether I'm talking to the police officers, whether I'm talking to politicians, whether I'm talking to rappers, I try to maintain the same person in that same energy.
Yeah.
If it supports my growth and my goals. So, you know, compartmentalizing, I think the bigger issue for me is like just creating boundaries and being able to like turn it off. Like,
yeah,
you know
I got
what I'm
you.
Saying?
I
like,
got you.
Take a break. Go take a trip somewhere.
Yeah.
Reset. You know. Don't give so much that you are depleted.
Yeah.
So those are like the
you can't pour from an empty
if
cup.
I do,
you
if
can't
I
pour
do want to go out
cup.
And have a good time and like,
right.
Hey, I'm off work. Like.
So and literally, like, luckily for me, like, so I go out and work with the kids, right?
Mm-hmm.
But when I need to recharge, when I need somebody to pour into my cup, shout out to Master Coach LaKendra, the owner of Jice Loves from East Dallas, Texas. West Dallas. Where is Pinkston? West Dallas, East Dallas? West Dallas, Texas.
I'm about to say,
y'all
I'm
from
Houston.
Other side. So West Dallas, shout out to Master Coach LaKendra, Jice Loves. From West Dallas, creating a seven-figure business that allows me to be the person that I need to be for other people. And her mission is to help leaders lead with love. She's the person that pours into leaders' cups.
Gotcha.
Because where do the strong friends go?
Yeah.
When you deplete it?
Yeah.
Where do I go to get a refill? Where do I go to get my nourishment and my food? And where do I go to be held accountable?
Yeah.
That's where I go. So find y'all a place to go, especially if you the strong friend.
Yeah.
Y'all the strong friends.
For sure.
Everybody call on you for support and help.
Yeah. Whole
it's
family, everything.
Yeah. Yeah, so where do y'all go to get your refill?
I told you, I just started therapy. Because for a minute, it was like, it was just me and I was just going to figure it out. Now, my wife is supportive. She's always there, too.
Okay.
But I told him, I was like, bro, I'm going to see a therapist. Because to your point, I had to take a break. I was burnt out.
Uh-huh.
And I couldn't recharge up. I have other friends back at home in Detroit, but like in Houston proper, it's just me and my wife.
Okay.
So I finally took the step. To your point about insurance and all that, I found out my insurance covered it to where it was only like $30
oh,
a
wow,
session.
That's
now the dude was charging $150, Yeah. So the fact that it was 30, I'm like, all right, we'll bet. So I'm every Monday, I start my week off with a therapy session in the morning.
That's what's up. That's a beautiful thing.
But I want you to know this, Coach, because a lot of people will come, and I'm sure you've seen this. Mm-hmm. You'll give a prescription or a plan, but they don't do it. I commit. I'll show up and be active and participate in whatever my therapist like with the plans and stuff that he roll out for me. I apply the shit like week to week.
Yeah.
So I can do it though.
Like, so that comes with a process, you know, just unlearning, relearning, deprogramming, decluttering. Like that just takes time. You just have to, like I said again, love, empathy, compassion. And so most therapists and life coaches, you know, give you that space, that safe space. To do that, to grow. And I would say for the audience, for the people listening, so that you have an understanding of what is a life coach. What is a life coach? A life coach is somebody who can help you develop, achieve, grow, whatever your goals are. But the thing is, the only person that can fix your life is you. We just are a coach and a guy.
Yeah.
We do not have the skills to fix your life because you already know the answer. Just like you the problem, you the solution. So I will say to give an explanation of what life coaching is. So with therapy, so if you think about, like, let's say cancer, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So if you were to contract cancer, y'all knock on wood three times. If you were to contract cancer, you have two ways to heal. Right, you can do the holistic approach, or you can go take chemotherapy.
Mm-hmm.
Life coaching is the holistic approach to mental health. We normally do not prescribe. We're just going to help you identify what you're dealing with, make you aware, and help you develop the skills to fix your own shit.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And so for a life, so that it's clear, I want people to have a clear understanding of mental health because it's so taboo in our community.
It is.
I be walking around, I be seeing all the mental health issues on people. It make me not want to come around you motherfuckers.
Yeah, yeah.
I got friends and family. I got to tell all the time, like, you should get therapy.
But I do because I'm charged and I'm called to do this work, so I'm going to continue to do it.
Yeah.
I'm going to show up in the fire. But so... understanding therapists can help you with present and past.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
By degree, because when you're dealing with trauma, unpacking those things requires a degree. I don't want to unpack something and I land on a landmine and you blow up on my ass. Life coaches deal in present and future.
Oh, okay.
So just to have a
clear understanding of
how a life coach can help you.
Okay.
And for our company, we're the only life coaching company that does this until people start copying Jesus. But so what that means is, like, we give all of our clients that are seen through Medicaid, all of them see a LPC or a therapist first. And then the life coaches, they'll diagnose them with whatever issues we're dealing with, depression, anxiety, academic underachievement, whatever you're dealing with, and then the life coach kind of meets with that client once a week.
Gotcha.
So you're getting that clinical support, and, you know, you're getting space. And then the life coaches have their own individual niche, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you're getting somebody that you can really, 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 really relate to.
Yeah. Because I one of the things that I struggled with was empathy. I have a two-year-old daughter,
uh-huh.
and as she was being born, I realized that's something that I have to work on.
Yeah.
And so I feel like I've been doing a better job of it. Like she'll be three in June, so the past 3 years for sure. But growing up, I realized, like, I didn't have a lot of empathy, like, outside of, like, my family and stuff, right? Mm. And as a black man in this world, especially starting a family with my wife and my daughter, I'm around these women, like, I have to be able to empathize and be able to, like, you know what I'm saying, kind of understand their emotions and develop my emotional intelligence. Like,
okay.
That was something that I realized for myself I had to work on.
So,
for me, when I did therapy, a little bit of time I did, I was on the opposite end.
Mm.
I had too much in it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then how did that translate into your behavior? Like, having too much empathy made you do what?
Always want people to, like, want help from me.
Mm.
So you always wanted to help?
Or like, I'm always trying to be like that. Like, oh, no, whatever is going on, it don't matter if you're just a coworker. Like, oh, you need help? I got you. Like,
oh, okay, that sounds like people pleasing.
Yeah, people pleasing.
Oh, okay.
My therapist says, she's like, yeah, you suffer from superhero syndrome.
Yeah, you can't say that, hoe.
They don't want to be saved.
No, they may want to be saved, but that hoe got to save herself because why? She the problem.
Yeah.
Hoe, you the problem.
That's
say
real.
Yourself. Say yourself. Go find you a life coach. Go get you some positive friends. okay, yep. That's doing better than you. Go get you some friends that's doing better than you. If you the smartest one in all your friends, you the dummy. Get you some smart friends. Get you some people that are smarter than you. Get you some people that don't look like you. Get you some people that don't speak your language.
Yeah.
And watch how you elevate. Mm-hmm.
That's real. That's real. Coach Adam, y'all. Yeah. Coach Adam. Coach, tell them where they can follow you at, and then tell them about your company again, or like where they can sign up if they're looking for it.
Okay, so listen, guys, you know, I also do branding and marketing consulting. So I'm just on TikTok because TikTok is where it's at. Follow me, Coach Adam, Gifted Purpose Life Coach. You can follow me on Instagram, Coach Adam Morris, Coach Adam Morris, Coach Adam Morris on most platforms. On Facebook, it's just my government, Adam Morris. But yeah, you can follow me on all those platforms. You can go to JiceLoves.com. And if you do not have Medicaid, no worries. We have a $247 a month subscription to Mental Health Life Services, y'all. This is a steal. Okay, so you get 30 minutes and four sessions a month, or you can combine those four sessions and get 2 one-hour sessions for just $247 a month. And I also want to say we are doing our national Leading with Love tour. So we'll be in Africa, we'll be in Dubai, we'll be in the Philippines, and we'll be in the United States, Brookhaven Country Club. That's our home in November, December. So just look out for that. Teaching people how to lead with love, you know. And yeah, follow me on TikTok because that's just where my focus at, because it's just changing the game for marketing.
Yeah, this is dope.
Look, before we hopped on, Coach Adam was like, nah, bro, you got to get on TikTok. Stop bullshitting.
Get on TikTok.
I'm there. I'm on there. I don't be using it right, but I received that word. Like, okay. I got you.
It's just, you know, eat the meat, spit the bones. Whatever works for you, you have the answers to your own problems. And y'all, be kind to yourself, be kind to others, and show love. That's it. That's what Big Mama wanted.
Facts.
And I'm out. I'm Coach Adam.
Facts.
Yep.
This has been another episode of the Inaudible Ruckus Podcast. Make sure you subscribe on Apple, Spotify, SoundCloud, Stitcher, Pocket Cast, everywhere where podcasts are. You can also find us on iHeartRadio app. Also go to the website, inaudibleruckus.com/shop. Make sure you go to our YouTube page, subscribe there. Make sure you go to midnightclubmerch.com. Also support Naturally Nay. Make sure you subscribe to her YouTube channel. Also, you can purchase her products on the Inaudible Ruckus website. Okay, we got the Naturally Nay Moisturizer Dual. It's rated E for everybody. So, women, it works for your natural hair. If you're trying to, like, grow out your froze, get your locks and everything going. Fellas, it works for your locks and beards as well, too, right? So, it works for everybody, right? We even using some of it on London, Baby London, and it's growing her hair, too. So, just something to consider there. But it's time to get up out of here, man. And like my OGs used to tell me, go with God and fuck the rest. It's an Audible Ruckus, motherfucker.